great to have you with us for Saturday Night Baseball here at Nord Oval, brought to you by SA Power Networks. Time for the lineup introductions, and we'll start with the visiting Brisbane Bandits. Would you please draw your attention to the first base dugout? And we'll start off by welcoming the manager. The manager of the Bandits, Dave Nilsson. And now the Brisbane starting lineup. Leading off, centre fielder, number 2, Johnny Field. Batting second, the K-man, third baseman, number 18, Mitch Nilsson. Batting third, the second baseman, number 6, Tommy Coyle. Batting four, the left fielder, number 23, Grandon Getzman. Batting five, the catcher, number 8, Max Tissenbaum. Batting six, the first baseman, number 43, David Sutherland. Batting seven, designated hitter, number 17, Andrew Campbell. Batting eight, right fielder, number 19, Josh Roberts. Batting nine, the shortstop, number 16, Logan Wade. In the bullpen, tonight's starting pitcher for the visiting Brisbane Bandits is number 4, Masaki Takashio. And would you please also welcome the assistant coaches and the non-starters of the visiting Brisbane Bandits. Some great news. We have the Warradale Primary School, and they're ably assisted by Chomper and the fearless Grant Wilson, and they're helping the Bite out there with the introductions. Fantastic. Welcome to the Warradale Primary School. Okay, we now draw your attention to the third base dugout, and we can begin to welcome our very own home team, the Adelaide Bite, brought to you by SA Power Network. Starting off with the manager of the Bite, Brooke Knight. And now the Adelaide Bite starting lineup. First of all, leading off, second baseman number 20, Brandon Dixon. Batting second, centre fielder number 17, Mitch Dening. Batting third, the first baseman number 29, Aaron Miller. Batting four, at third base number 22, Stephen Welsh. Batting five, the catcher number 34, Craig Maddox. Batting six, the right fielder number 21, Ben Lodge. Batting seven, the shortstop number 7, Chan Jong Moon. Batting eight, the designated hitter number 35, Angus Roja. Batting nine at left field, number 32, Corey Lyon. And in the bullpen tonight, starting pitcher for your Adelaide Bite is number 28, Morgan Coombs. Okay, now we can prepare to welcome the official adjudicators of tonight's game. Oh, yes, of course. But first we'll do the coaches, assistant coaches and the non-starters of our very own Adelaide Bite, brought to you by SA Power Networks. Okay, now we can welcome the umpires. Here they come, give them a big hand. Umpires are led out by Blake Halligan, who will be calling the balls and strikes. And looking after the bases, we have the crew chief, Neil Poulton and Andrew Bell. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we now ask that you would all be upstanding, remove your caps and draw your attention to the area just in front of the pitcher's mound as we prepare to honour Australia with the playing of our national anthem.
Australia. So good evening, everyone. Saturday night baseball here at Cooper Stadium in Adelaide. And after a very, very interesting sort of day with a lot of thunder and a lot of lightning, again, about 3 o'clock, it's just cleared and it is picture-perfect conditions here to play ball. So the Adelaide Bite currently in a four-game series, 2-0 up. My name's Andrew Spurling with my partners Peter White and Jim Manning. We are the 10th inning and we are very happy to be bringing this to you tonight. I've been joined by my good buddy and I'm really happy to have a fellow like Ian Revel in here with us because Ian, not only a wonderful baseballer but also now doing the rounds of the umpiring and not far off getting a start right out on that diamond in front of us, Rev. But it'll be good to have him here, not only with his baseball knowledge, but to just give us a little bit of knowledge on umpiring decisions and adjudications and all sorts of things. So welcome, Rev.
Thanks, Bill. So very nice for those lovely words tonight. As you're right, we've had some bad weather out here today, and the weather looks like it's cleared up and the sun's out. So hopefully we don't have the same problem as we did up in Brisbane where we won the first two and then the Bandits got back into the series and squared it off.
That's exactly right, Rev, and that's the challenge. All right, to get excited and think everything's running rosy, but anything is possible. I'll just quickly run through the lineups with you. For the Bandits, Johnny Field will lead off again at centre field. Mitch Nielsen slots into the two hole, playing third base. Tommy Coyle's at second base. Grandin Getzman is at left field. Max Tisenbaum. Dave Sutherland jumps back out into the field at first base. Andrew Campbell's DHing. Josh Roberts is at right field. Logan Wade will play shortstop. And Masaki Takashio will pitch for the Bandits. And for the Bite, Brandon Dixon will lead off at second base. Mitch Dening at centre field. Aaron Miller first base. Steph Welsh third base. Craig Maddox jumps behind the dish tonight, hitting five. Give Rocky Gale a bit of a rest. Ben Lodge at right field. Chen Jiang Moon shortstop. Angus Rozier at DH. Corey Lyon left field. Morgan Coombs, the wily Morgan, will take the mound for the Adelaide Bite. And it should be a pretty good matchup, Rev.
Well, I think it certainly will, Andrew. You'd have to expect Brisbane to come out a little bit stronger tonight, especially after a close one last night, and then the shellacking they got on Thursday night. So hopefully we'll see a different Bandit outfit tonight.
Yeah, well, exactly. And, you know, as we saw last night, they gave nothing away, and they certainly didn't die wondering. They kept coming. They kept coming, and it really took a wonderful effort by Williams just to hang tough and not get too flustered and just rely on getting that third out, and eventually it did in the 6-5 victory to the Bite, but it was awfully close, and again I think the Bandits would have got something out of it too. So this is up for grabs, this game tonight. Anything is possible, and we had a chat with Morgan here during the Perth Heat tournament last weekend, and he's a wily fox. He's not an overpowering pitcher. He's got his slider that he throws at different speeds and just sort of different little arm angles. And a guy that started off in the field with his career and realised he had a decent arm and got pushed into the pitch. And here he is in Adelaide, Australia, trying to further his career.
He actually has a lot of on his fastball, Andrew. The ball nips and tucks around home plate, so getting good movement off the ball makes it a little harder for the hitters.
Absolutely. So we're not far away from the first pitch here in Game 3. Hope you're all sitting in and enjoying yourself wherever you may be. And it's going to be our pleasure to bring this game to you tonight. A really important game. Every game's important, but right at the moment with everyone winning and losing and no one really clearing out, these wins are extremely important.
You've made a great point there, Andrew, that, as you said, there's no clear outstanding team at the moment, and you get a series where you think that you're going to dominate and then a team will come up and bite you in the bum, and that's what you need to keep the competition strong.
Well, we might say that, hey, it's a long season and there's plenty of time, and you're dead right in thinking that also, but as we see, if you lose games early, all of a sudden with your equation, with 15 or 20 to go, it means you've got to win 14 of them or something to perhaps get where you want to be. So the Heat well and truly gets on, and it's going to be a very interesting game tonight.
It's always tough in these early stages of the game, Andrew, with the sun coming over the grandstands for the right side of the field. So, yeah, they have to be very aware of what's happening out there.
That they do, and Coombs winds and delivers and gets one across for strike one. Doesn't matter who, where, how or what, every hit is the same when it's not exactly where they thought it was. They have a little peer and a little look, and there's Coombs again wheeling a slider outside for a 1-1 count. As we said, beautiful night here. The shark tank down there is bulging. We've got extras in tonight. There's nearly 100 people in that shark tank tonight. And there's again a nice slider a little up and in, and gets him swinging through.
So that's going to be his number one pitch, that slider, just to get a bit of movement on the ball and trying to make the hitters miss the mid of the bat.
And he comes again. And there it is. So he gets a strikeout. Johnny Field, lead off for the Bandits. We've got 40 mixed sort of softball night in the shark tank, and we've got a fair few people tuning in that we know around the place. A good friend of ours, Daryl Saw, it's his birthday today, so shout out to you, Sawy. Mitch Nielsen, it's a low fastball outside that he has a half swing on. And this time he comes inside, 1-1.
It looks like Morgan's got good control, and he's probably going to work these hitters in and out all night to, just to try and keep them off their toes.
And that's a good caper, and I think one of the, and there he is again, just floating, or what seems to be just floating, a nice little pitch outside, kept it down, gets himself a 1-2 count, being a guy that spent a lot of time in the field and hit, he knows what people like and what they don't. And there's another slider, and just throws Nielsen. Beautiful sequence of pitching by Morgan Coombs.
If you can get the pitch to come in off the outside and take the outside edge, and you freeze a lot of these hitters because they're not expecting the movement, and he's done that once again for another strikeout.
So Tommy Coyle had a big series against Melbourne. We've been able to subdue him. He's been playing some good flash in the leather at second base, but just hasn't quite struck it up just yet. But there's a couple of games to go, and it can all change pretty quickly.
Coyle come around for a bunt attempt, and the ball was down, so he's let that go for ball one.
Coombs. Sorry, mate.
That's okay. I was just going to jump in there and say Coombs comes back with a fastball on the outside, middle outside part of the plate. As I said, he's not overpowering, but he's just good location by the looks of it. Fouls that one off the right field line for a 1-ball, 2-strike count.
And you mentioned about he's been blessed with a bit of athleticism, and you can watch him up there, and he pivots on that leg, and he twists around, and he's got some real lovely agility, and it just enables him to, you know, have varying release points and just different timing with his pitching, just sits and waits. And there's nothing, as we said, overpowering, but what you'd probably regard as a bit of a funky sort of pitcher, Rev.
Certainly has the funk factor going. As I said, not overpowering, but just has that little tweak on the ball to keep the batters hitting and guessing. Coombs misses inside again for a full count.
So Coombs again, fastball outside, and again it's that ability to be able to stay around the zone, keep the hitter guessing, and then really his change-up is his fastball. So he strikes the first three hitters out for the Bandits. Wonderful start for Morgan Coombs. See you back here in a flash. Back everyone. Japanese Masaki Takashio climbs the mound for the Brisbane Bandits. As we mentioned last night, got quite a few Asian imports with pitchers Goto and Takashio from Japan, Huang and Lin from Chinese Taipei, bit of Canadian in there with Shergill, Americans, a few Australians.
Hopefully Adelaide can get off to a good start here again tonight to keep on their winning way.
So Takashio starts it up with the fastball up and out, 143 clicks, so jumping straight into his work.
He's only a slight framed guy too.
He is, but they're normally so beautifully fluent and mechanics, so solid. And he gets one down and in for ball two. Great to see the Saturday night crowd in. There's plenty here. The word's getting around that the Bite are mounting something, which is always important. Everyone loves a team that's winning. Been a bit starved of that consistency over the last couple of years, and by no means popping off, but as Dixon pops up, bit of a challenge for Goof, looking right into the sun. All too easy for the big man.
Yeah, just going on what you're saying there, Andrew. Brooke Knight seems to have got a good group of guys together. Very good defensively, and the offense has definitely picked up from previous years, so hopefully they can keep that going. As I said, in the early parts of this game, the sun will come into effect out on the right side of the field. Until the sun goes down, they could have a bit of trouble.
Definitely with the line drives and the flatter shots, they're the ones that really, because you get no chance to, you know, get a good look at it and get it out of the direct sunlight. And Dening pulls that one hard. Foul.
Mitch Dening has made his way over from Sydney, unable to get into the lineup in the Blue Sox, so he's ventured over here for the Bite, and he will be a handy acquisition, playing centre field and hitting with power.
So Takashio then gets a fastball up and out, and again jumps on it. Foul ball. Again, he gets out in front on that one and pulls it hard down the first baseline. Foul. This Adelaide lineup loves to swing the bats, and certainly probably a whole lot better than seeing guys fussy hitters. There's time and a place for everything, but to see guys that really like to swing the bat, it's exciting. We've certainly scored a lot of runs.
The only way to get the runs on the board is to swing that bat. And they've been doing it very successfully over this series. Dening fouls off another one for a one ball, two strike count.
So Takashia delivers change up. Dening, the desired result, and Goofy will get an easy put out. It's a good job there by Takashio. Knows that Denning's a little bit eager at the minute. Ended up throwing a nice little change up down that he got out in front on and rolled it around to first baseman Sutherland. So welcome to everyone wherever you may be, as we said before, and got some Brisbane people tuning in here with us. Well, in the beautiful old Brisbane.
Takashiya misses in the first pitch for a one ball count. Just trying to get his zone organised.
And he hits Miller. So first runner jumps on board. And Aaron Miller got a fastball in that got him on the way through.
Brings to bat Stephen Welch, local product of SA. In the minor leagues over in America, working his way through.
Free agent at the moment, Revler.
Ah.
So playing for opportunity, and one magnificent aspect of him is his demeanour and his understanding of this game and the ins and the outs and the ups and the downs. There's not much. Steph just stays on the same plane. Win, lose or draw, good or bad. He's a great asset. He's a terrific player and he puts a good swing on that.
Steph liked that fastball down the middle. Unfortunately, only got a foul ball.
So a couple out here for the Bandits. Welsh in the box, Miller on board, misses up. Even for the pitcher, Arrighty, just getting that little bit of glare as he's sort of trying to pick his signals up. Won't be long and it'll be all clear for them, but still a little bit. You can see his face is shining a little bit. The sun just getting it and he gets a nice pitch in. So he strikes Welsh out and Takashio gets the job done for the Bandits. We've got a nil all ball game as we push to the second. See you back here in a moment.
SA Power Networks employs more than 2,000 South Australians and delivers electricity to around 840,000 customers. We don't make electricity, and we don't sell it either. What we do is deliver electricity to your home. From Mountain to our airport, hospitals, schools and traffic lights, power is vital to the function of our state. That's why our team is on call 24/7, rain, hail or shine, to respond to any emergency. Plus, we're taking the initiative to ensure that everyone can access information about their power supply however and wherever they like. We also foster vital connections through more than a dozen community sponsorships. At SA Power Networks, we're working with you to deliver the power you need, now and in the future.
Welcome back to Norwood Oval. The Bites just going through their warm-ups before we start the second inning, the top part of. Behind the dish tonight, we have an international umpire in Blake Halligan, a local product of SA.
a little bit of feedback last night that our stream is a little jerky. Extremely frustrating, and tonight and tomorrow, generally a different story. So stick with us, should be a nice, easy flight tonight. So Coombs gets a little tailing fastball outside for ball one. And Getzman, I think I was calling him Getzman, perhaps trying to be a little European and no clue whatsoever. So we'll just stick with Getzman, Rev. And he swings through that one. He had an absolute rope last night. Straight through left field. It nearly knocked the stand down. Absolutely crushed it.
Yeah, it looks like Getzman does have power, so Coombs will have to be on his toes here.
And there it is.
He's got that slider working nicely. Obviously, Getzman hasn't seen that pitch, so he's just getting his eye in it, making sure that he knows what sort of movement he's got to deal with.
And that's the challenge for them, if they can take that away from him and put a couple of good swings on that pitch, and there's that one just a little softer for 2-2. Just looking for a mistake swing by the hitter. But Getzman doesn't hit in the four hole because he's lacking ability. He saw it early and took it. He comes inside, just misses a few inches. So the wily fox winds himself up and comes again, and there it is. The strike gets him out.
Coombs is on a bit of a roll at the moment. It's number four strikeout for the game. Got the perfect record happening. Hopefully he can keep that control up.
Well, there's still plenty of arms left for the Bite, so he'll know what he's got to do, and I'm sure he's got fifth inning in mind. At least, and if he can get there, it'll be a job well done. And he just eases a fastball over for strike one. So again, that's his understanding, that knowing that Tisenborn will more than likely take here 4 Ks in a row, he's not going to go early and just be a cheap out. He flips a slider outside for 1-1. A really interesting series so far, and Tisenborn gets a change up and he swings straight through it.
What we're seeing here, Andrew, is Coombs has wonderful, wonderful control here. He's keeping the hitters guessing. Very rarely will he give them the same pitch twice.
It's a beautiful vision. Wonderful team, and there's a ground ball to Dixon, and he laps that one up and throws him out.
It's two out for the Bandits. And finally, the Bandits don't get a strikeout.
See, with Sutherland, Welsh well off his line. In actual fact, they've got a shift going for him. We've got shortstop Chan Moon playing second base side of the diamond, with Dixon filling the big hole.
They've obviously done their groundwork, and they've worked out that he is just a straight pull hitter.
You know, Rev, even if he may not be, but you know, when you look at the field, it makes you think, I've got to go the other way here. It's the only way I can really work this out, and I'll show them. So it immediately has a mental adjustment for you. And there's that ground ball. He's going to need a little bit of a hand. He does it himself for a put-out three. So another high-quality dig by Morgan Coombs. He goes bang, bang, bang again. So six up, six down for the Bandits. We'll see you back here in a moment. here. Part about going to the ball game is knowing that you're going to get a bit of bang for your buck, and kids have a great time here. There's some wonderful on-field stuff by the crew. All interns from America sent out here to gain opportunity, and they do a wonderful job. You just can't underestimate how difficult it is to be out on that field and looking back at everyone and trying to engage with them and make it a really good night at the ballpark.
Got to try and get the spectators out here, Andrew.
And they're doing a pretty good job at it. We've got perhaps our best crowd in, I reckon, of the nights that we've had so far.
Let's hope the weather gods stay nice.
So Craig Maddox, assuming disc duties tonight, takes a fastball right down the pipe, 134, strike one.
Takashio goes inside again and gets just out in foul territory down first base for the first out for the Bite. Brings to bat Ben Lodge. Starting to make a good impression in the competition.
And there's the shift again. They did it to him all last night. They just pound him in. They know that he's got some good skill and he can go inside out and drive hard to centre right alley. And they're going to take it away from him. So they shift. Second base comes over. Shortstop fills the hole. They leave the whole right side open and he tries to pull that one. He gets a little foul tip on the way through.
It's always good to watch how a hitter handles this pressure when an opposition does a shift on them.
Well, Lodgy's been doing all right and they've got him on the swing. Tried to hold himself back. He saw it again and he lit up the eyes, but that was up and he just could not hold himself back. So one ball, two strike count with one out. Bottom two, nil all ball game. And that was a pitch to hit. And that's probably what it does to you, Rev, is it? You start to think too much and think, okay, they're going in on me and I've got to do this or I've got to do that. And you get a fat pitch and perhaps you're just not in a real good position to put your best swing on it. So 1-2. Comes down and in.
No, you're right,
Spells. Just misses. Tisenbaum wanted it.
You're right, Spells. It just puts a bit of extra pressure. And when you see that one down the middle, sometimes you try and overswing it and pop it up or ground it out. 2-2 count here on Ben Lodge.
Shio comes in and gets the job done. The mind games continue and they get their result. Lodge strikes out.
The shortstop, number 7, Chan
Jong
Moon.
So Moon dropped down the list. Been normally leading off, had a big night Thursday night. Hung in there and got a nice shot from the right side at his last at bat. He's a switch hitter. No good left, and then switch right and just drove one up the middle, hit it hard.
Had a very good night on Thursday night. Got one to disappear over the fence.
And they come inside on him and get one past him. 1-1. He's a very capable baseballer. Got some beautiful hands and lovely range. And got that typical Asian swing. If I could generalise so much, but it just dip out of the box and quick hands through. When they connect, they go. Takashio comes down and in and oof, just misses again.
That pitch just off the plate.
Blake Halligan had a good look at it, was in beautiful position, stared it down and decided ball. 2-2. And
Moon
punches that one into centre left field. Rounds first, base hit,
There's the first hit for the game. Moon driving one into centre left for a single.
Good hitting. Just stayed with that one instead of pulling out. He stayed with. Got that barrel out there.
Basically just put the pitch back where it came from. That's good hitting. Brings to bat Angus Roger. Angus has the DH duties tonight.
McCullen talked him up last night and he delivered. And he'd like his chances. Not if they keep coming hard in at him.
Rogue takes a fastball down the middle. Middle to inside for strike one.
So both pitchers doing a good job here at the moment. Takashio just gives his 3 out of 10 move just to say hello.
Yep, just to keep that runner honest. Make sure he doesn't get too far off at first base.
And he's off Moon. Roger goes with him and flies it to right field. Josh Roberts underneath. The sun in there a little bit, but no worries to the old campaigner. He takes it easily. So we still have a nil all ball game as we push to the third. We've got a very tight little ball game on our hands. Stick with us. We'll see you back here soon.
The Australian Baseball League and the Australian National Team
exclusively. SA Power Networks employs more than 2,000 South Australians and delivers electricity to around 840,000 customers. We don't make electricity, and we don't sell it either. What we do is deliver electricity to your home. From the Rundle Lantern, to our airport, hospitals, schools, and traffic lights, power is vital to the function of our state. That's why our team is on call 24/7, rain, hail, or shine, to respond to any emergency. Plus, we're taking the initiative to ensure that everyone can access information about their power supply however and wherever they like. We also foster vital connections through more than a dozen community sponsorships. At SA Power Networks, we're working with you to deliver the power you need, now and in the future. SA Power Networks employs more than two.
Can you hear that popping sound, ladies and gentlemen? You know what that popping sound is? It is freshly popped popcorn. Hot buttered, freshly popped popcorn. It is available exclusively from the canteen area under the main grandstand.
So welcome back, and as is the norm, the third dig, and just beautiful efficiency between the 10th inning and the Adelaide Bite. We've got Tyler Bruneman back up with us here tonight. So he had a little bit of a jaunt with us or so ago, but welcome back, Tyler.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you for having me again. I had fun last time, so I figured I'd come back again.
Good job, and as we said, always a chance to connect with your friends and family back home. As we said, there's always the time difference, but hey, they'll catch up with us, especially on YouTube. Tyler, so
Yeah, a little late back in
there. Nice shot there by Campbell. Shoots it along the third baseline. Welsh was playing off that line, which is fair enough for a lefty, and he drove it along the line for a base hit. So he threw a few digs last night, Tyler, and did a little setup job and did a good job.
Yeah, felt all right last night. You know, it's going well. Got away from me a little, gave up a run, but kept us in lead, so I guess I did my job.
Did your job.
Got a nice W again. Go up in the series 2-0.
Absolutely, and the boys are travelling. Plenty of arms left in that pen, so.
Oh, yeah, set up well for the rest of the weekend, too.
Who we got down there, Tyler? Who's going to be?
Well, we'll have Will Mathis and Troy Scott will throw out of the pen today. A couple of Mariners guys for sure. And then I think just depending on the game situation the rest of the way, we'll see who else throws. But Morgan on the mound right now looking good. So we'll just keep rolling with him as long as he's pitching well.
He's a real funky dude, isn't he? And when he's able to get that slider over, it's hard to stop. And he's a back to front sort of guy. Just gets you on your heels a little bit, and there's an attempted bunt, but Roberts can't get it in play.
Just pushes that one down the right field, the third baseline. Attempted bump, trying to get that runner over to second base.
Yeah, Morgan's definitely a different pitcher. Not the typical pitcher. He's different than one I've kind of seen, but he does well mixing his pitches, and he actually, one of the things he does unique is he kind of changes his motion up every once in a while, and it throws hitters off, and then mixes his pitches well, and yeah, his slider's definitely his go-to pitch, and when that's working well, he's throwing well, and as you've seen tonight, he's already had a couple strikeouts on it, so.
Absolutely, got four. The first four are all strikeouts, so.
Looks like he gets late movement on the slider too, which is always a deceiving thing for a hitter.
Yeah, definitely. Late movement on all his pitches pretty much. That's the key to him pitching well, because he's not an overpowering guy, and he knows that, so.
So time called, and a little bit of disappointment. Campbell got a pretty good jump, but just all at the same time. Chief calls time.
A little bit of a late call there. I think Campbell will have to blame his own hitter for that one, the late call. So
he had the bag swiped, I think.
He was definitely going to take second base on that one.
The Coons come in and finds the spot. And you're right, Tyler, he's got a lot of agility. He's a very athletic sort of guy, and he's got quick feet, which certainly helps him with pickoffs. And we said it as exactly what you just said. He sort of pirouettes on that back leg sometimes and swivels and just takes a little bit more time. And there's another strikeout. Can't complain about that. He's getting them over the plate, and they're just not ready and not getting any decent swings on them at all.
There's the good slider right there we were just talking about.
Yeah,
just freezing him on the outside corner.
Yeah, they just look like they're not getting a good read on that slider at the moment, and he's just bringing it back over the plate. And Blake Halligan rings up another one.
And another week in Adelaide, Tyler. All gone well for you. Some nice sun and sunshine.
Yeah, definitely. Had a little rain this weekend, throwing us off a little, but it stayed away during the game.
Yeah.
So that's fine with me, as long as we can get the games in.
Get the games in, and as you said, we've been a bit lucky, but the grounds actually came up pretty well. The little bit of a chat about the extra clay that they put into the cutouts, that they might be a bit sticky. Any of the boys, any mention?
I haven't heard any complaints from the hitters about the cutouts, but it's been looking pretty well. Hopefully the mound's holding up well tonight, we'll see.
Just seen a great move by Coombs trying to get the runner at first base, but he's just got back in.
He's got a good move to first, actually. Again, those quick feet, and when he gets that pick off perfect, and it just rolls into the mitt. He's only inches in it, and Wade drives one out. Denning's got a bead on it and takes the catch. So two out.
We'll have to get your thoughts, Tyler, on when you get to January, when it gets up to 42, 43 degrees.
It's the weather's been great since I've been here so far. It hadn't been too hot, but I've heard that it's going to get hotter here. So we'll see how I enjoy the weather once it's up into the high 30s and 40s around here.
It's coming.
So I guess I'll enjoy this November a little bit cooler, nice weather, while I can.
Corey Lyon attempts a bunt, two out, a bit of a running bunt, just to try and catch the infield off guard. Unfortunately, fouls that one off.
And without getting too far ahead, Tyler, just looking ahead to, January, February, and obviously it'd be lovely for us to still be playing into late January, but what's on your schedule from there?
Not a lot on the schedule, just playing baseball, and I know next week some of us imports guys are putting together a little Thanksgiving, because it's Thanksgiving back home for us, so early next week before we head out to Melbourne. Is that where we go next weekend? Is that correct?
It's a good question, Tyler.
That is a good question. Maybe something I should know.
Something I should probably know, too.
You stumped a lot of us.
Yeah, sorry. But, yeah, early next week we got a nice little Thanksgiving meal together, so that should be a good time.
Oh, fantastic. And a lot of you boys are bunking together. You're sort of sharing houses together or not?
Yeah. A few of us are in apartments together. I'm in an apartment with Moon and Craig Maddox, actually. And then a couple of Dodgers guys together and the Mariners guys together.
So. Johnny Field lifts that center field again, and Dening just rounds it up, takes the catch. So we retire the Bandits as we complete the top of the third. We just have a short break. We'll see you back in a sec. Back again. Takashio winds up the big Nord Oval mound. We'll roll on. Nil all the score. Moved into the bottom of the third. Got Tyler Brunneman, part of the staff here of the Adelaide Bite. And we've talked a lot about the arms, and we've got lots of them. And all been doing a pretty good job, Tyler. Everyone looks in good shape, and our pitching statistics have been pretty strong.
Yeah, pitching's been pretty good for us, and hitters are doing well, too. I know last weekend, just kind of as a team, as a whole, we kind of struggled and still got out of there with the series split with Perth. It was a real good team. So, I mean, not happy about that, but if we can kind of struggle and still split, That's good news for when we're playing well, and see what we can do then.
Absolutely. And Lyon goes first pitch and pops it to the infield, and big first baseman does what he should do and takes charge and takes the catch.
Yeah, you're right, Tyler, that the split with Perth was good in the end, but I know that Brooke was looking for a three-win or a four-win series, and that's always going to be tough against the Perth Heat. They're the reigning champions, so... But yeah, to split it 2-all,
yeah,
come back well.
Yeah, and definitely, hopefully, we take this series, especially being up 2-0. Last time we dropped the last two to them, and that was pretty disappointing. We definitely feel like we shouldn't have done that, but I think we're looking good. Lineup, I think our hitters, we talked about when I was up here last weekend, our hitters just first pitch swinging a lot, and I think this weekend we've been a little more patient, and it's been good for us. We've been hitting the ball well.
I agree, Tyler, and as we spoke, you know, it's good to be free swingers, and we've got some hitters, and they like to let it rip, but, you know, you got to wear that pitcher out. You know, that's where a team that comes into it, the sooner that we can delve into the pen, generally the sooner that things start to happen. So, and that's a bit of a dedicated effort by all hitters to make them throw strikes.
Yeah, definitely, trying to get to the pen as early as possible, make their bullpen throw a lot of innings on the weekend will help us.
Takashio went for a breaker and lost his balance.
Andrew just pointing out that we have a good crowd out here tonight, which is great.
Dixon lifts that. Centre left field. Getzman calls his centre fielder out. Glove side and takes the catch.
Just didn't get enough of that ball and got it up in the air a bit too high. First out of the bottom of the third inning. And we're likely to see you out there tonight, Tyler?
Yeah, there's a chance I'll be out there tonight. I think it kind of just depends on the game situation for me, but I'm up and ready to go tonight if they need me, so hopefully we have the lead late in the game and I'll be able to get in there.
Oh, that's good, Tyler. That's very durable to, you know, you must have gone at least three yesterday, I reckon.
No, I went one and a third last night, so.
Geez, I'm obviously paying great attention.
Yeah.
I just like watching you, and maybe it just seemed like a long time, Tyler.
Yeah. Well, I know that the second inning I went out there got a little long, so maybe that's why you thought let a few too many base runners on.
And just as the amazing thing that Willie sort of all of a sudden was going along quite nicely and then got in a little bit of strife with back-to-back-to-back hits, I reckon, and Kyle sort of jumped into the pen and just looked a little bit under when he came out last night, not being critical. Just looked like it caught him by surprise. He's been pretty sharp and he just didn't seem to be right on his game last night.
Yeah, we were talking about that today, me and Kyle, and you know, he knows what he was doing. He was just kind of jumping out there, and but he'll be fine. He'll get back out there next time, and I'm sure he'll get right back in form and keep continuing to pitch well.
Yeah, absolutely. He's a big man, and he's been throwing it really well, and as I said, it was just a little bit unusual of his normal standards, and hey, we can all have a day where it just doesn't quite go according to plan.
Yeah, that'll happen. Will Lee looked great last night. It's great to have him back after he missed last week pitching with Team Australia. And he looked real sharp throughout the game. And then that last inning where he gave up the three hits in a row, one decent hit and then a couple bloopers fall in. And that's just baseball, kind of just some bad luck there. But overall, his fastball looked real good and he was throwing it past a lot of guys.
Yeah, and that's been probably Wilson's challenge, Tyler, and it's good to sort of talk to you about it. He's certainly got some capabilities and he's got a bit of giddy up on the ball, but just getting people out has been his biggest problem.
Yeah, I haven't seen him pitch a lot. That's only the second time I've seen him pitch. But I know there's definitely a lot of potential there, and as long as he commands the zone, I've heard he might get a little wild sometimes, but as long as he's commanding the zone, I think he looks good.
So Denning strikes out. We complete three. And I've chopped in on you again, Rev. I'm sorry. We'll just take a short break again. We'll see you in a moment.
SA Power Networks employs more than 2,000 South Australians and delivers electricity to around 840,000 customers. We don't make electricity, and we don't sell it either. What we do is deliver electricity to your home. From the Rundle Lantern to our airport, hospitals, schools and traffic lights, power is vital to the function of our state. That's why our team is on call 24/7, rain, hail or shine, to respond to any emergency. Plus, we're taking the initiative to ensure that everyone can access information about their power supply however and wherever they like. We also foster vital connections through more than a dozen community sponsorships. At SA Power Networks, we're working with you to deliver the power you need, now and in the future.
Sorry, folks, we're back, and Tyler left his mic on, so he's probably tuned into our little convo, which was Rev's left his mic on. Can't trust anyone, Tyler, not pros like you and me.
Yeah, I thought I had turned mine off. I had to check, make sure.
So a few little comments here on YouTube. Morgan probably sits about 132 or something generally with his fastball and can get it down to as low as 90 with that sort of his varying types of speed that he likes to throw his pitches at. So exactly right, viewers. He's not overpowering, as we've mentioned, and it's all about variation and just getting the feet of the hitters wobbling and moving and not sure. And then he can spit a fastball in just to bust you up a little bit.
Yeah, definitely. And I don't know the kilometers conversion as well, 132, but I know he usually pitches in the low 80s. So, but he's definitely, he's a fun guy to watch pitch because just general day in, day out, he's very, very excitable, high energy guy.
Mm.
And just always joking around and messing around with guys. But once he gets pitching, he's just locked in the zone and he's ready to go, no distractions. So that's kind of a complete turnaround there.
It is. He is a jovial character, isn't he? And just fantastic to have around the place because it's a tough game, baseball, and you know, you got to ride some real lows when on occasions. And there he is again, just going back to front. This time just a 1-2-5, but just location perfect.
Mitching the pitches up enough to keep the hitters off balance and get them guessing, and Mitch guessed wrong that one.
Yeah, definitely. Looking off-speed pitch there late in the count, and just spots up a fastball. Keeps him looking right there.
Tommy Coyle takes one with him. Just a sensational bunt. They're pleading that goes out of play, and it's right on the line. Set it itself just beautifully for Tommy Coyle, but it was a great bunt.
Nothing that Morgan can do on that one except just let it roll until it stopped, and unfortunately it stopped on the line.
Nothing at all. You picked that one up and he's going to be safe, so just a perfect bunt there. Can't do much about that one.
If the ball is on the line and kicked out.
Sorry, go again.
If the ball is on the line or right around it and it's kicked out.
The ball is in play. The ball has to clearly be off the line. The pitcher can then knock it out. But
anyone can knock it out.
Anyone can knock that ball out. But if the ball is on the line, it's still in the field of play. And as you said, Tyler, yeah, there was nothing that Morgan could do on that one except let it roll. He was going to get safe, so he might as well just let that one trickle.
Yeah. No sand down the lines here either, so no lip. You're hoping that ball will kick on. Just nothing you can do there.
And that ball's Getzman is flowing it. Miller will come in and take the cap. Not. He'll be disappointed with that. He's a high-class player, and that was money for the jam for him, but hey, we can all make blues.
Something's caught Miller's eye there. It just popped into the glove and popped out.
So Getzman is given a chance. He's the type of guy that we've seen. He's got a bit of pop. He can hit.
Hopefully the damage is minimal.
Here's that quick move by Coombs again. Just spins those feet and releases in a matter of moments.
We'll probably be looking at a good amount of sliders right here to Getzman, especially 1-1, as long as we don't fall too far behind. He's a guy that'll chase out of the zone. He swings a lot. He'll swing at just about anything.
So Coyle's got some wheels, I think, between him and Johnny Field. They're right up there in stolen bases, something like 6 and 5 or half a dozen each. So a threat on base, and Morgan knows it. So he's spending a lot of attention to the runner, and he sets, and he goes again. Beautiful pick off. How much the pitchers work at picking off, Tyler?
I think it just kind of depends on the pitchers. If you you don't have to work on as much, but guys are a little slower. There's a good slider right there.
Just as you were saying, Tyler, this hitter's going to be swinging at anything.
Yeah.
Up in the zone, and gets that little slider away and misses it.
I'd imagine we'll probably just see another one right here and hopefully get another swing through.
Miller at first base would be sweating on this one, seeing as he's given the hitter a life.
Oh, good fastball right there. He, at the plate, he was definitely looking for the slider. I know I was looking for it, but caught him off guard. Just put it by him right there.
That one's taken the edge on the outside, hit the black, and Coombs picks up another strikeout.
And not only that, I saw Coyle sort of edging back to first base on those couple of occasions too, so even though he had a big lead, he was still well aware of Morgan's capability to get one over there pretty quick.
Yeah, he's got a quick move to first, and that's good keeping those base runners over there. Oh, got him caught.
Maddox, unfortunately, has thrown that one to the wrong side of the base, and Coyle's got the second. A good throw would have got him there. Tyler, I noticed that Maddox has stepped in behind the dish. The first few series, Rocky was the job behind the dish.
Yeah, Rocky will be, I feel like he'll catch more games in the series, definitely. But Craig has experience with Morgan. They played on the same team for 3 years now, so I think he's just comfortable with this matchup with this pitcher-catcher-battery, so that's good for Craig to get behind the plate, and he's done a great job behind the plate too. He's a really good receiver. He calls the game well. He's an older guy, definitely knows baseball well and knows how to call a game.
And pretty handy for Rocky too, because it's a big job to, you know, catch every game and hit and be competitive, so it's good for him to have a little rest here and there.
Yeah, catching four games in a row is definitely tough, so I think Rocky will enjoy the one-game rest in the series.
Morgan misses down and away on that pitch on a fastball. Do you find it very different than being back in the States, where you're playing a lot more regularly than what we do in Australia?
Yeah, it's definitely different, only playing four times a week and then get Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday off. I'm enjoying it.
He goes inside out. Lyons comes across, or Lyon comes across and takes the catch. So that was a pretty good cameo by Corey last night when he came on, making a double play and then a stinging catch out there. It was a hell of a 5 minutes for him.
Yeah, made a couple of great plays out there in the left field, and mainly a third baseman, so I was a little surprised, but he looks great out there so far.
We'll take a short break. We'll see you back in a moment.
SA Power Networks employs more than 2,000 South Australians and delivers electricity to around 840,000 customers. We don't make electricity, and we don't sell it either. What we do is deliver electricity to your home. From the Rundle Lantern to our airport, hospitals, schools and traffic lights, power is vital to the function of our state. That's why our team is on call 24/7, rain, hail or shine, to respond to any emergency. Plus, we're taking the initiative to ensure that everyone can access information about their power supply however and wherever they like. We also foster vital connections through more than a dozen community sponsorships. At SA Power Networks, we're working with you to deliver the power you need, now and in the future.
So welcome back, everyone. Not much separating this game at the moment. Both pitchers doing a good job. And the Bandits have thrown three more hitters into the box than us, but we're owed an inning. So it's a very tight little affair right at the moment.
I'm not sure how you feel about it, Tyler, but I'm an ex-pitcher and I do like the close games.
Yeah, definitely. Low-scoring games are fun, but I'd like to see us with the middle of the order right here. String a couple hits together, maybe put a few runs on the board.
Yeah, we just need to seem to have to break this game open a little bit right now.
Yeah, it's a good spot to do it with the 3-4-5 hitters coming up.
Now the baseball game rolls around as Miller leads off, so he gets an immediate opportunity to jump straight in the box and try to help himself out, but he pops it up. Logan sits and wobbles around a little bit, but ends up taking the catch.
Takashio just seems to be working the inside part of the plate on most of our hitters. Obviously, he's got the confidence that he can beat our hitters. Brings to bat Stephen Welch. Just come back from Australian duties.
Yeah, he's looked real good being back so far. He's a really good defensive third baseman. He swung it pretty well. I'm pretty impressed with him.
He's been around a long time, Tyler, and he's a, as you probably notice, he's very stable sort of guy, and not a lot of emotion. He's been around the baseball scene a long time.
Yeah, definitely. He's very comfortable with baseball, knows what he's doing out there, and he's also another good clubhouse guy, leader, a guy who's been going to keep the younger guys on track.
And he gets one off the handle, so ditto, a couple of lefties in a row get jammed and popped to the infield.
It just looked like Steph was trying to squeeze up on the plate to make it a little bit harder for Takashio there, but still able to get it a pop up to shortstop for the second out.
So your roomie strides to the plate. I had Jamie McCohen up last night, and he's with Corey Lyon, so he was pretty happy with Corey's little cameos.
Yeah.
Let's hope your roomie can give you something to get excited about.
Absolutely. He's looked great at the plate so far, too, getting knocks and...
Field. Getzman cruises underneath it. So a pretty cheap little dig here for Takashio. The Bandits would be happy with that, so we move to the top of the fifth. Nil all ball game. Stay with us.
They got the Bandits again. Now let's go out and get the Bandits ourselves. Make some noise!
So welcome back, everyone. Tyler has left the commentary box. Sorry we didn't get an opportunity to thank him in person, but again, always great to have him up and just good to pick their brain and answer some questions, and people at home get to hear something that maybe they were intrigued about. And
no, he just sounds like a very nice guy.
All
very
been
friendly.
Nice guys. All been really nice guys. Absolute credit to themselves and their families.
You're very right there. And And that comes down to the organisation knowing that there's a certain person that they're going to be bringing out to give some experience to. And they've definitely picked a good one there with Tyler.
Yeah, and I think as Bryce said last night too, that really nice bunch. There's often, and you know, no blame to anyone, just as the world works, there's always a couple that don't seem to mix and mingle and just maybe break that dynamic of the room a little bit. But all of these boys getting along famously and really each other's company, and it's visible. And Goofy, he pops one. And again, Coombs and Chan Moon, who the shortstop positioned himself behind second base, and it would have nearly gone straight down his throat.
And that's the shift that just seems to be working right there, that Moon's on the second base side of second base and takes an easy pop-up.
So Campbell, who shot one down the third baseline at his last at-bat, which is probably the idea for lefties and righties, let the ball travel, especially to a guy that's not going to blow it by you. And he waited and waited and drove it straight down the line and got himself a base hit.
Coombs just missing on that first pitch on the outside edge. Ball one. Campbell drives one up the middle, straight out to Mitch Dening for a single. He's in a little bit of form tonight.
So incredibly enough, Rev, no matter what we see, whether, you know, a guy's got most people stitched up, there's always a couple that you can't get out.
There's always that one person in the lineup that just, no matter what, and as I said, he's Coombs is dominating the lineup, and unfortunately Campbell's his nemesis tonight, and he's picked up his second hit.
There's Robert swinging through it, change up, 77 mile an hour.
It's just good to see Mitch, that he seems to get that first out. So a hit in that situation, it doesn't bother him, it doesn't faze him. So he just gets back on that mound and keeps doing his job.
And then there it is again, has a little nibble. Yeah, just misses down low outside.
Yeah, that slider looked like it was trying to come around the back part of the plate, but just missed for a 1-1 count.
So Campbell probably not going to be as big a running threat. And again, Morgan Coombs doing a beautiful job with that slider again.
Just knows when to throw that slider to get him a strike and get in front of the count. One ball, two strikes.
So it's a real guessing game at the moment, a real game of chess, especially facing Morgan. These guys are trying to outthink him, and right at the moment he's getting the job done. And there's another just little chopper, and he said, look, I'll do it myself, save any potential mistakes.
And that's the beauty of Coombe, that those little dribblers up the first base line, he's able to get over there, grab that ball and carry on to first base to make the touch for the second out. Campbell advances to second base, two out in the inning. Brings to bat Logan Wade.
Hit a fly ball out to centre field at his first at bat. Again, just a pleasure to watch a youngster like Logan Wade climbing the ladder. Another really nicely balanced kid. Beautiful hands. And he can hit. So Coombs, runner on second, two out, delivers the slider, and she rolls across that plate again. And they've got to start to, as a team, do something about this. Otherwise, he's going quite economically at the moment, and you could see him still around in the seventh if they can't do something pretty quickly.
His pitch count would be extremely good at the moment. Hasn't had to extend himself, hasn't gone to too many full counts. So Brooke Knight would be very pleased with his starter tonight.
Coombs again just misses outside, nicely supported by Maddox. Super important for a, not a junk baller, but a guy that relies on his off speed, that the catcher is right on the same wavelength and just a brick wall behind there.
Yeah, he's got to get down and block those ones that are in the dirt. Can't get, allow these runners to get extra bases.
And there's that fastball again. And you could see Wade thinking again, I've got to get this slider, I've got to do something and show my team. But he pitched that fastball 1-2-4 Ks that completely just broke his timing. And another strikeout to Coombs. We'll be back with you real soon.
SA Power Networks employs more than 2,000 South Australians and delivers electricity to around 840,000 customers. We don't make electricity, and we don't sell it either. What we do is deliver electricity to your home. From the Rundle Lantern to our airport, hospitals, schools and traffic lights, power is vital to the function of our state. That's why our team is on call 24/7, rain, hail or shine, to respond to any emergency. Plus, we're taking the initiative to ensure that everyone can access information about their power supply however and wherever they like. We also foster vital connections through more than a dozen community sponsorships. At SA Power Networks, we're working with you to deliver the power you need, now and in the future.
So here we are again, we're racing through this game. Both pitches, economy would be very strong at the moment.
Sorry, Spells, just noticing that Morgan Coombs has racked up 8 strikeouts, so he's doing an exceptionally good job tonight.
Yeah, well, I saw when on the strikeout list when he came back from Brisbane, he had a decent number of them. So, you know, and we can see why, because he's a strikeout pitcher, and you sort of think, oh, how could he possibly be that, you know, he doesn't throw the ball hard enough. But it just goes to show, you know, it takes all types. And if you command your pitches, as you said, and you're looking at him and seeing him in really good rhythm and feeling really comfortable with himself and just loving the opportunity to work with Maddox, and he's just picking when he wants to throw a pitch, and I'll throw it for a strike or I won't, and he's in full command.
Exactly right. And Lodge takes the first pitch up and away for ball one. Yeah, you can just see the combination's working well with Maddox and Coombs. It's Takashoe. Throws a fastball. Ben Lodge fouls that one off for a 1-1 count. The sun's completely set now, so we're under lights here at Nord Oval. Hopefully Ben Lodge can be the start of a big inning.
Takashoe misses outside, just down and out.
I noticed Tyler talking about our last innings when we had 3, 4, 5 up, but at this level, you line up hits all the way through.
Oh, heads up, FA Power Network. Making all the power yours to take home.
So they've got, still got the big shift on Lodgie.
As I said, Ben might just have to change his thought process in the batting box. If he gets that pitch on the outside part of the plate, he just drives it into centre right.
I'd suggest he's trying to come in, and he tries to come in again. That's certainly been the form on Lodge.
If you're going to do this, if you're going to do the move on a hitter, you've got to be throwing to the location that basically says that this is where we're going to get our out. We're going to get him to drag that ball into the left side of the field where we've got the three fielders. So the pitcher's got to do his job as well.
So Takashoe to Lodge, the breaker. He took something off at 129 and just sort of missed a little up and out. Don't think they exactly wanted it there. Should have got the catcher just. So they set inside again. And he comes. And Lodge strikes out. So he didn't exactly hit the spot. But again, I think the mind game is working well enough. And Lodgy strikes out.
Yeah, they looked like they were setting up Ben Lodge on the inside part of the plate. But the last pitch, the strikeout pitch, was an outside fastball. Which always makes it difficult for a hitter.
So Moon with the only hit for the Bite right at the moment. Tries to bunt himself on and that was up for ball one.
Yes, Moon needs to try a different tactic. As I said, this game's flying along. Time to break it open with something.
So again, Takashio comes inside this time and misses. One and one, nil all ball game. Bottom of the fifth. Sorry, 2-0. And that's inside two. 3-0.
Moon's worked the count really well here.
Gets one across.
Moon maybe thought that was a bit up, but Blake Halligan says that that was a good pitch. Three balls, one strike on Moon. Takashio misses with a fastball up. The ball one.
So Corey Lyon just blasted a two-run shot over right field at Josh Roberts, flailing back to the fence, but all to no avail.
That's Lyon's first home run for the season.
A nice swing, Dixon outside and fouls it. So a little two-out rally here for the Adelaide Bite. Now leading it 2-0. Bottom of the fifth.
And leading the series 2-0 as well. This is what Brooke would have been looking for. Get themselves into a position to take a series 4-0.
So Dixon being in pretty good form. Would like to keep this going, and he misses outside. So Takashio leads it up. So Dixon picks a walk after a two-run shot. Tied as, and there wasn't much happening, and now after a two-run bomb we see Takashio walk the next hitter. Bring to the plate the very dangerous and overdue Mitch Dening.
Yeah, Mitch brings a lot to the game. He's a power hitter. He's dominating in the home runs for Adelaide. Has a sweet swing.
Dixon was on the move there a little bit too. Caught going the other way.
Takashio just keeping you honest. Welcome back everyone. It looks like the stream's back up and running. Sorry for that delay. Dixon's got a handy lead out there and Takashio's just making sure that he's doesn't extend it too far. Takashio's got himself into a bit of a hole here after giving up a two-run bomb and then a walk to Dixon. Brings to bat the lethal Mitch Dening. A late swing.
He's out of there only by millimetres, but that's all it needs to be. So Tissenbaum helps the pitcher out and gets the Bandits out of the dig. But the Adelaide Bite via a two-run bomb by Corey Lyon go 2-0 ahead. We'll see you back here very soon.
Welcome back to the game, ladies and gentlemen. We move into the top of the sixth inning. Morgan Coombe still on the mound and dominating. Starts the leadoff hitter with a slider, just missing down. Prepares the throw, comes in with that slider again and evens up the count, 1-1. As we've said before, Andrew, Coombe has wonderful, wonderful control of all of his pitches tonight, and that's keeping the Bandit batters at bay.
Yes, it sure is, and he's got plenty of energy, and Welsh gathers that and fires it across for an easy out.
Yeah, Fields just tried to drag a slider outside, and he's dragged it down the left field side, down to third base, for an easy pickup for Steph Welch. One out.
So Mitch Nielsen. He's been stitched up tonight thus far. A couple of K colds.
Yeah, he's just lacking confidence, and he's swinging early in the count, and that you know that you've got him. Coombs gives him a change up. Slider just missing on the outside edge.
Hard down the first baseline, foul. So one ball, two strikes. Top of the sixth here, Adelaide Bite leading it 2-0. From the wind up, Coombs drops those hands and tries to get that slider across, but swipes that ball when it's given back to him. Not overly happy with that little pitch. Just got out of whack a little bit.
Yeah, that one looked like it came out of the back of the hand a little bit and released it high.
He comes inside. So no activity in any bullpen right at the moment, believing both starters have got some more work to do. It might be that's wise for Adelaide, I reckon, to maybe get somebody up and moving slowly. And there's Coombs again coming in.
That's the beauty of watching Coombs here, Spells, is that he's not fazed. He can throw any pitch at any time. Even though we've got a full count on Mitch Nielsen, he'll keep throwing a strike in there to get him to ground out or pop up.
And as you'd know, Rev, especially when you feel you got someone, if he could even get a slider sinking in the dirt, he'd probably get Mitch swinging. And he swings and he pulls that one. So a lot better by Mitch, making some adjustments and not over swinging, just working and waiting for the ball and making contact.
Yeah, Mitch Nielsen's struck out both times tonight. And we have a check swing call, but it's ball four. Mitch Nielsen
picks a walk.
Gets a walk up to first base. Mitch would have been sweating on that call from the third base umpire and Neil Poulton. But it went his way and he's now on at first base.
So no doubt the Bandits people would be thinking it's time for Tommy to uncoil and let one rip and get his team well and truly marching back into this game. He's just the man, the quality to do it. And he takes a fastball and there's again just the variation and the inconsistency of Morgan to, they just don't know really what's coming at the moment. He takes a 118k fastball a little out.
Yeah, he's not setting any patterns, so the hitters can't work off of anything. They've just got to go on the pitch.
Again, he tries again with the fastball but misses.
Yeah, that one just missing low. As I said, the Spells with pitchers on both teams dominating. It's very hard to work out how long you're going to let them go.
And there's that slide. And across it goes.
He has them mesmerised with that pitch tonight. And as we speak, Adelaide's pen is starting to get some activity.
So from the set, he delivers a slider in. Started it right in the centre of the plate and it cut its way in for a ball. So as much as it is to throw pitches with a lot of movement, and you've got to start them in the right area to get them across where you want them.
That's right, yeah. You got to try and get the hitter to miss the pitch with the movement that Coombs is getting tonight.
He's a hard hit ball, possible double play. A 5-4-3, and the Adelaide Bite are on fire. And they've got a 2-0 lead. Bottom of the sixth coming your way. We'll see you in a moment.
SA Power Networks employs more than 2,000 South Australians and delivers electricity to around 840,000 customers. We don't make electricity. We don't sell it either. What we do is deliver electricity to your home. From the Rundle Lantern to our airport, hospitals, schools and traffic lights, power is vital to the function of our state. That's why our team is on call 24/7, rain, hail or shine, to respond to any emergency. Plus, we're taking the initiative to ensure that everyone can access information about their power supply however and wherever they like. We also foster vital connections through more than a dozen community sponsorships. At SA Power Networks, we're working with you to deliver the power you need, now and in the future.
So welcome back everyone, our wonderful partner SA Power Networks, major sponsor and supporter of the Adelaide Bite and the 10th inning. And we thank them very much, Russell Duncan and the crew. Greatly appreciated. So we move to the bottom of the sixth. Adelaide with a 2-0 lead.
I'd like to get a couple extra here just to give them a bit of a comfort zone. And we always welcome our followers on the internet with their comments. Keep sending them in and we'll try and get a comment across for you. To lead off the bottom of the sixth inning, Mitch Dening from centrefield. Takashio still on the hill for the Brisbane Bandits.
Oh, and Dening gets a fair bit on it. He actually liked it off the bat.
And that ball's gone out of here.
We'll soon see. Yes, it is. He's pounding those bases. And Johnny Field's gone through that same panel that Mitch went through last night, I reckon. And Dening breaks his slump with a long ball straight away centre field. Third run on the board for the Bite.
Off the bat, I reckon Mitch might have known that that was going deep. He had a bit of a stutter step and watched that one drift over the centre field, Ted.
As they scurry out to centre field to fix some problems, we'll take an opportunity to have a quick little break. We'll see you in a moment. So welcome back everyone, repairs are done and the Bite with none out, bottom of the sixth, through a long ball by Dening, go 3-0 up.
Miller drags that one near foul down the first baseline. Brook Knight would be breathing a little easier now that he has another run for a buffer.
They're all valuable in a tight little ball game. It'll be interesting to see what the plan is from here for the Adelaide Bite.
Yeah, Coombs has done his job extremely well tonight and Adelaide Bite's pen is full.
Maybe the type of guy, and again Miller gets one on the foot, so he'll walk his way to first base, hit pitch ball. And sort of Morg just sort of seems the type of guy that he, because of the type of pitcher he is, that maybe you just can't let him go too long. You know, it could turn a bit nasty perhaps pretty quickly, and so the timing of his exit is paramount. So Nielsen comes out to have a little chat with Masaki Takashio.
And that drags the whole of the Bandit infield in for a chat. Miller's been hit twice tonight.
And there's going to be a pitching change.
Yeah. I'm just noticing that Miller, he does squeeze up on the plate, so he's obviously not afraid to take a pitch. Takashio departs from the game in the bottom of the sixth inning.
Done a wonderful job. We'll get you up to speed with who the reliever is. We'll just take a short break. We'll see you back here in a moment. We'll be right back. So Daniel Cooper comes to the mound. He had a little bit of work in game one, where they aired the pen out a little bit when they were well down, and just cruised through and gave everyone a little bullpen, just a little tune-up, knowing that they will be back for bigger things. And Cooper comes into this game chasing a few runs with a big job to quell the bats while his team can try to bounce their way back into this game.
Yeah, just noticing that Daniel Cooper, a slightly older player that's come out from the United States.
So it doesn't get any easier with the lefty, Steph Welsh, coming into the box.
Steph Welsh is due for a good time at bat right now.
None out, and the batter is Stephen Welsh.
Cooper throws the first fastball on the outside part of the edge for strike one.
138 clicks. So immediately into the mid 80s. And they're very upright. We get
almost had Miller going the wrong way there. But he dives back in with his hands and gets safe. Perfect situation here for Steph Welch.
Miller's off, trying to swipe another bag, and another great throw. And just the location of the throw was the winner there. It would have been a real boom boom, but he had nothing but to just slide straight into the mitt, and the ball got there just before him. So another beautiful throw by Tisenbaum. And again, Brooke Knight tries to keep the screws well and truly twisting. And Cooper would be happy with that. One out.
Tisenbaum's doing a great job behind the dish. That's the second one he's thrown out tonight. His location at second base has been inch perfect.
Welsh gets that off the handle. He pops it directly behind, and it just comes down the other side of the backstop. And no play on that ball.
Just looked like Brooke Knight was having a quiet little chat with Andrew Bell at third base, the umpire. But a great call.
I think both of his calls tonight on boom booms have been on the money.
Been spot on.
So the big righty, Cooper, delivers again, breaking pitch and leaves it up. A cutter or a slider or something.
Yeah, that last pitch that Steph fouled off, he was out in front of it. Needs to really concentrate here. Cooper prepares the throw. Steph fouls that one off again.
Could be coming back, get ready. Press on. Oh,
2-2 count to Steph Welch. And he swings and misses for strike three. The second out of the inning.
Craig Maddox. A couple of pop ups tonight.
Had an unusual batting stance, Spells.
Again, a lot of lefties. Dixon, Miller, Welsh, Maddox, Moon, although he's a switch hitter. He takes a pitch downstairs for ball one. So with one out, bottom six, Adelaide Bite leading it by three.
Cooper misses again from the outside part of the plate for ball two.
So Cooper working from the set. Maddox swings through one.
Not a real confident swing there by Maddox.
No, got fooled a little bit, I think. He just... It was a bit of a half-hearted swing.
It was indeed.
Especially, yeah, the 2-0 count, and no doubt he loaded himself up and just committed and realised I can't hit this. So 2-1 the count now, and a breaking pitch, and he gets plenty on it. Goes strong and long. Centre-right field. Oh, Johnny Field went back. Got right in the correct position, but he just tipped it off the top of his glove as it came back into play. So bad luck for Johnny Field out there, but a nice long ball from Craig Maddox.
I reckon Johnny Field might have just made contact with the fence there, and it's just thrown his glove hand off the ball a bit, and it's popped out. So this innings continues on for Adelaide Bite. Now brings to bat Ben Lodge.
His replacement on second base, the pitch runner, is Michael Miller.
So it'll be interesting with the shift here, Rev, too, and how they might manage any attempt to keep the runner at bay as well, even though Coyle is directly behind him.
Yeah, we're in a slightly different situation now with Ben Lodge and the Bandits having a shift on. We do have a runner at second base. Does change it a little bit as Cooper prepares to throw to Ben Lodge. Ben swings and misses on a pitch on the outside part of the plate,
and it looked like Field went all the way back to the fence, and just as he got super close, he got a little bit unaware and not happy with his situation, thinking I'm going to crash this fence any moment, and it was just enough to give him a stiff mitt. It seemed to just sort of go in and bounce out. So you'd have to call that a double or an error. Be thinking an error, would you, by the way you looked at me then?
I'm a pitcher, so an ex-pitcher, so it's going to be an error for me.
Not next guy.
That's what he's paid for, to do to take those catches. Ben Lodge drives the ball to the right side. First baseman fields it. Pitcher covers first base. The side away.
So we'll be back with you. That was a 142 k an hour fastball. And we got the run down the choppers. We'll see you in a moment. Morgan Coombs will continue on his stuff as we move to top seven. So still this ball game very much within reach of either team. And the leadoff will be Getzman. And Coombs starts it up. Fastball outside for ball one. You heard Bruneman say that they've already noticed that with Getzman, he's a free swinger. He'll swing at anything and anything, anywhere. So and they'll no doubt be trying to get a couple over and use that killer pitch that he's got. So terrific crowd in that just continued to come tonight, and he gets that one off the handle, hits it around into the shark tank area, and it choppers in there, nearly caught one on the head. So Morgan Coombs working his way through some shutout baseball right at the moment, and there it is. There's that beautiful pitch that he has so much confidence in, and he gets it across again. 2-2 the count, and takes something off that slider and throws an extremely slow version of it. What he continues to do, in and out, faster slider, slower slider, loopier slider, and he gets that one off the handle and he pops it to the infield. Dixon all over it and receives it.
Spells, this is probably the deepest we've seen a starter go this season, has it?
Well, they haven't gone deep, so you're right, Rev. They've, I think Maddie in the first game might have ended up stretching out to seven, but you're right, everyone else has been around that sort of five-ish, six-inning mark.
Yeah, it just proves that Brooke Knight's got the confidence in Morgan to do the job.
And why wouldn't you? Playing some shutout baseball at the moment, nicely supported by the team.
Morgan comes in with another slider for strike two. He's only given up the three hits tonight and seven strikeouts.
We've got a little bit of a treat for you in the seventh inning stretch that our pitcher from last night, Colin Feldman, also possesses a very beautiful voice, and he's going to be singing "Take Me Out to the Old Ball Game" in between digs here, so we'll take that. And we see a young man with a bit of talent. It's Coon. Whips one, misses outside. So 2-2 the count, and he is in complete control here at the moment, and it's only be his fitness and durability that's going to keep him going or not.
It's just about to say the same thing, Spells, that Coombs is just dominating here.
And there's a nice little shot, and again, perfect hitting to a guy like this, not trying to overswing. Sat, waited, drove it opposite field. Beautiful hitting. Base hit.
Once again, though, that Coombs has got the first out, so a hit from the second hitter, not going to put him off that much.
So Tizenbaum does a good job there. Handy baseballer, Tampa Bay boy, as most of them are. Field, Coyle, Getzman,
Southern liked that first pitch, but unfortunately was only able to foul it off. But once again, Coombs gets in front of the count. Brooke Knight would be extremely happy.
And we've really missed Ryan Searle. Probably be their game three starter, and in such a tight little ball game. Not saying that Takashio hasn't done a good job, he did a wonderful job. Keep it going down to very low numbers, and you've done your job. You need some support from your hitters. But they just have not been able to crack the code on Morgan Coombs. And he continues to wheel away.
You keep some. He's kept them tidy and just worked them in and out, off speed. Just starting to miss here in the top of the seventh inning. Adelaide Bite's bullpen has scurrying over there.
Looks like Cole Mathis is... Will Mathis,
yes.
You wouldn't even know who Cole Mathis was, would you? There's a ground ball, second base, possible double play, but they just go for a force at two, and the throw was a little errant, and it just dragged Moon off the base. So there's a little break for the Bandits.
Yeah, they've done the right thing, trying to get the leadoff runner there at second base. But the throw coming in from the second baseman to Moon was just a ray. Dragged him off, and Andrew Bell has called that one safe. Good call.
So Brooke Knight's coming out to have a chat with Morgan. And maybe he might want to be keeping his little beautiful game just intact and send him off on a good note. As all the boys come in and have a good natter. Will Mathis continuing to warm up quickly. And they're all pretty young kids and they come to hand pretty quickly. So Brooke just, I think, just biding for a little bit of time there. And Morgan will continue on.
Brooke's probably just giving his relief pitcher a bit more time to get warm, so he's just broken up the momentum of the game. But Adelaide are still dominating here. Coombs prepares to throw to the next hitter.
So runners on first and second, one out. Best opportunity the Bandits have had tonight to capitalise on something. And it's not going to take much to get them back into this game.
No, you're right, Spills. It's only a three-run lead. So Bandits, good opportunity right here.
There's a ground ball again, second base.
Against the first leg. Had the force at second, got the easy out, but couldn't retire the batter runner. So now we have runners at the corners. Josh Roberts comes into the batting box.
So runners in the corners with two outs for the Bandits.
Adelaide hoping to keep their perfect record here tonight.
And I'm sure Morgan would be looking to finish his little job off as sweetly as it started. From the belt, delivers outside, ball one. Suggested this would be it for Morgan. Done a terrific job. Just looks like he's... those legs are just breaking down just a little bit.
Yeah, they've got a specialist, the reliever, who entered the game probably for the start of the eighth.
And there's right field. Lodge comes up throwing. But Roberts gets a base hit right field and picks up the first run for the Bandits.
Brooke Knight checks his dugout and the bullpen. And that'll be all over for Morgan Coombe tonight.
So we'll take a short break. We will... send to one of our sponsors, and we'll see you here back very soon.
Time.
just one more reminder, kids, if you lost your cap, please come up to the announcing area. If you lost your cap during the run across the field, come up to the announcing area.
So welcome back, everyone. And there's the decision of a manager.
Okay, Saturday Night Baseball, we're in the seventh inning.
Never take him out too early, Rev.
Never.
Only too late, but he deserved the opportunity to try to finish it off, or finish this, his bit of work off, and...
Morgan Coombs done a great job, 6 2/3 innings, only gave up the 5 hits and 7 strikeouts.
And then they've got to contend with the lefty throwing it in the mid-140s in Will Mathis. Another likely type. Nice and athletic and beautiful physique. So he has a bit of a look at second and delivers and comes in on Wade. 0-2.
That's what you need right now from Will Mathis. Throw plenty of strikes, get them out of this little bit of a jam that the Bite have got themselves into at the moment. Runners at first and second, one out. Two out, sorry.
And again, just in consecutive pitches, Will Mathis says, I ain't mucking around, I'm here to do a job. And he gets it done. We'll have a short break. See you back here in a second.
All right, Norwood, let's see what you got. Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jacks. I don't care if I ever get back for its root. Root, root for the Bite. If they don't win, it's a shame. For it's one, two, three strikes, you're out of the old ball game.
How about a hand for Colin Feldman? Well, we have a new winner for Nord Oval Idol, and there it is, ladies and gentlemen. Touching warm, reaching out, touching me.
So beat that, folks. Get somebody off your bench and see if they can pull off something like that. What a wonderful thing. Colin Feldman had a sensational outing yesterday. He's still got the energy to give us his rendition of the old ball game. So Cooper still out there rolling for the Banditos. They put one on the board at the top of the seventh to pull that deficit back to two.
I think Feldman's thrown out the challenge. He's just sung Take Me Out of the ball game in the seventh inning stretch, sending a message to all the imports around the country. Top that.
He's a two-way guy. He sings and pitches. So Cooper.
And lead off for your Adelaide Bite at the bottom of the seventh.
Leaves one up. Ball one.
Chance on Moon.
Nice pitch. Just a little down and a little out.
Yeah, Cooper's starting off a little tight here. Ball two on the batter. Moon. Cooper's in the set. Moon likes that one. Fouls it off into the dirt. Two balls, one strike.
So another great quality game of Australian baseball. Well, baseball in the Australian Baseball League. A bit bold of me to say Australian baseball. Rolls over that one and foul ball.
Took 11 innings for Sydney to beat Melbourne
12-8. Wow, a slugfest in Melbourne and Sydney in the 11th. Sydney get up 12-8. been a lot of big scoring games in the ABL.
And we have the complete opposite here at Norwood Oval tonight. Got a very tight ball game, dominated by two very good pitchers.
And as great as it is to see lots of hitting and running and all that sort of stuff, it's a nice mix to see some high quality pitching supported strongly by the field. And if you're going to get a hit, you're going to have to earn it, and you're going to have to be pretty good. Full count.
Moon fouls that one into the dirt and into the catcher's leg. See if Blake Halligan helps the catcher out and throws the ball back to the pitcher. Full count on Moon. As Cooper prepares to throw the next pitch.
A little shrug of the shoulders. And he comes and he gets the job done. He strikes Moon out.
Yeah, Moon didn't look too confident on that swing. Doesn't matter. Strike three. One out.
So in a very game of inches that baseball is, not long ago, Tucker Shaw was doing a great job and he left one up and Rozier banged him straight back through the middle, and you saw Tucker Shaw shake his head and he wasn't happy with it. It was just about then that it just unfolded. Lyon then hit him for a two-run bomb over right field, and that was the end of the night for Tucker Shaw. So it's a real fine line, Rev.
It certainly is, as I said, a game of inches. Roger belted one up the middle. Next batter up, Lyon disappears one over the right field fence. Roger takes a fastball inside for ball two.
It's a beautiful night here. Jacaranda's in full bloom over the shark net in right field. Oof. And although I think, again, the only thing that deceived us there was the catcher was a little in and he threw it right on the outside edge. And although you saw a little bit of the glove move significantly from the catcher, still definitely a strike. And Jarvis comes again and he comes down and in. So three balls, one strike, one out, bottom seven. Scoreline 3-1. The good guy's way.
And that's the beauty of a good catcher. He was able to frame that pitch to get strike one, but unfortunately Cooper's fallen behind the count.
Here's Rozier. Swinging and fouling that back between his legs to the backstop. And Corey gets it and throws it over to Timmy. He shows some wonderful skill. Takes a one-hander, Timmy Russell. So Cooper sets up again and comes in beautiful location. Down and out. You got Rozier swinging through it for a strikeout. So a boy that would like to wrap his little career up in a couple of days and take it home with him and look at it every night of the week. He's had a real incredible couple of days, Corey Lyon. Done some special things.
His confidence is riding high at the moment.
Grounds that one, third base. Nicely collected. And piffed on over by Mitch Nielsen. So we cruise into the top of the eighth. Adelaide Bite leading this one 3-1. We will have a short break and hear from our wonderful sponsors. We'll see you in a sec.
Bats to the ground, and you're going to spin around until I tell you to stop, and then run to Ashley. On your mark, get set, spin, spin, keep on spinning, spin, you gotta spin around, the faster you spin, the faster you'll run, you just gotta keep on spinning, spin. You got to spin faster, Kim. You're going too slow. You're going to run so slow. Faster. Spin, 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 spin. All right, run to Ashley. Run to Ashley. Run to Ashley. You can do it. Oh, Brisbane's getting back. Brisbane's getting back, and he's down for the count. And the Bandit loses, and Kim from Adelaide is the winner. Give it up for the Sam Bat Dizzy Race competitors. Sam Bat, the official bat of the Adelaide Bite. Set your own record.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you have ever done that, you know what I'm talking about. It is a very interesting thing. You lose all balance and semblance of where the hell you are. But we had a winner. And it wasn't the guy. So here we are, back, bottom eight. Top eight, I'm sorry. Will Mathis. 143 clicks and gets it in, and Johnny Field liked the look of it. Put a good swing on and snicked it straight to the backstop.
Spells, you can just see the confidence that Will Mathis is showing here. He's just going right at the hitters, saying, if you've got the goods, you hit me, and I'm going to keep coming and throwing strikes.
And he's got the goods, and he did hit him, and he blasts him straight to centre right fence, bounces off it. Denning collects, he's got a strong arm, he hits his cut, but Johnny Field leaves the Bandits off in the top of the eight, up double to give him some serious hope. That's what you like about these guys. They just continue to apply themselves, regardless of whether they've had a great night, a good night, or not such a good night. Here he is at his fourth at bat and really showed some pop and hit a rope to centre right field.
Brings to bat to Mitch Nielsen. Now that we have a lefty on the hill for Adelaide, he's switch hitting.
And he does the job. He gets it to the right side. Miller trying to feed and stop. Feeds it over to first base Mathis, but the boggle was enough to get the job done. And a beautiful bit of hitting there by Mitch Nielsen. Just leant on it. Just went right side. He knew what he had to do. He just had to push his runner. And in doing so,
he's forced the mistake from Miller at first base. And now Bennett's a really... in a good position here, runners at first and third. Rocky Gale goes out for a chat with his pitcher.
So we've got a change, but our defensive catcher comes in Rocky. And again, jumping on out, setting it all up, just letting everyone know, corners covered, none out. A real opportunity here for Brisbane. And Rocky is right with it.
Perfect scenario right now would be a double play for the Bite, allowing Brisbane the one run. But Adelaide will keep the lead.
There's a nice slider by Mathis, but he misses downstairs. 4-1. So we've got another tight one, folks. Take all out. Banana Benders are loving it. They're biting their way back into this game.
Certainly can feel the tension building here at Norwood Oval.
And again, the man that stepped up with us tonight, and Tyler Brunneman, is also in the pen doing some work. So they're going to, again, use the right-left sort of situation that they've got.
Tommy Cole has a wild swing at that pitch. In front of the count with two balls. Now we have a two ball, one strike count. Adelaide need to be tight here. Will Mathis misses down low. The 3-1 count.
If you miss, you miss down. And that's what he's doing. He's got some nice velo going. He just needs to just find a strike for himself right here. He goes over to first just to relieve a little bit of tension. And this game is hanging in the balance.
Brisbane Bandits are certainly lifted in the eighth inning here.
That ball swung and fouled. Got plenty on it. Couldn't square it up. Foul ball. Full count, none out.
Clutch pitch required right here.
Definitely be interesting to see what Brisbane do here with the runner as well. Always much more difficult with the lefty. And he goes over the first.
Yeah, the Bandits don't want to get into a situation here where the hitter hits into a double play.
This is one of Rocky's specialist moments too. He's pulled off a couple of K2 to sixes. Let's see what they can come up with here. Runner stays. And hitter strikes out to Tommy Coyle. Strikes out swinging.
That's a great pitch from Will Mathis there. Just got it up in the zone. Coyle couldn't keep his hands back and swung through to get the first out.
And they're going to follow the traditional way here and just keep going left, right, left, right. So that'll be the end of Mathis. He hands it over and Bruneman will come in and look to do his part of the, uphold his part of the bargain. We'll have a short break. See you in a sec.
New pitcher for your Adelaide Bite is number 20, Tyler Bruneman. Bruneman number 23 is the new man on the mound for the Bite. Okay, folks, we're in the top of the eighth inning. Saturday Night Baseball brought to you by SA Power Network. The Bandits have one out in the eighth inning. Tyler Bruneman, the new man on the mound for your Adelaide Bite.
Welcome back, folks.
And batting for the Bandits, Grandon Getson.
Tyler Bruneman enters the game for the Bite to try and get him out of this little bit of a squeeze that we have in the top of the eighth inning here.
So the 10th inning hoodoo continues. Every time we have somebody up here to sit, they enter the game. I'm not sure Tyler, even though he said he was up and he was ready, perhaps saw himself doing a little bit more work tonight. But he gets a breaking pitch and he gets it over inside. 0-2. So the pen come out throwing strikes, and that's what they're there to do.
Two strikes on the hitter here. Tyler just missing down on that one. One ball, two strikes.
And Josh Tolles steps into the pen as well. So keep on rolling it through. They've got the arms. They're all fresh. And there's a little blooper up the middle. Oh, as is so often the case where that ball skids through the dirt, that you often see a guy make an error there. Not necessarily his fault, but he just got a little jump.
Opens up the window a little bit for the Bandits. Still one out. Runners at first and second. This is where we need Tyler to really grind hard here.
So they're playing some pretty good baseball with the Bite, but they've made a little error or two. Been just enough to squeeze open that door for the Bandits, and they're coming back to a one-run ball game.
Brunneman missing inside with a fastball.
Here we got warming up in there. Japanese boy again. I think Goto might be having another little bit of work tonight. Not exactly sure whether that actually hit the hitter on Rocky. Tried to have a little backdoor play to first.
Yeah, I think that one just stuck to Rocky's hand and he's dragged it into the ground and threw it to second base, luckily.
So Brunneman from the set delivers, and it's a pop-up to the infield. Not very happy, Tannenbaum. And although Chan Jong did a little slippery little couple of backward steps, he caught it. It's all he needed to do. So a pop fly six for Tizenbaum.
It could have been a dangerous ball for Adelaide then, but Moons attacked that really well, got back on it. The outfielders weren't going to get near that one. And Tyler retires the Bandits hitter. What a great catch from Moon.
So still with a couple on.
Job still to be done here.
And Goofy takes a big hack at that. One of the biggest hacks I've seen the big man take. He really launched into that one. Liked it, saw it.
Sutherland tried to
cut the ribbons and had a rip.
Yeah, tried to get the lead off that hit. That swing, sorry.
So it would certainly make Brunneman a lot more cautious, and you'd expect something breaking. No, down. There's a big shift. Dixon, beautiful play. Well done.
Great play by Adelaide.
Super deep and right in his hole. And Sutherland just smashed it at him. It was all about flashing some leather, and he sure did. A great job by Dixon after making a blue at the previous play. And the Adelaide Bite retain with a one-run lead. We'll go bottom eight real soon. Welcome back, everyone. Bottom of the eighth, right in the money time, and it is well and truly on for young and old here.
Yeah, the Bandits have breathed a little bit of life back into this game, but Adelaide were able to withstand it. Tyler came in and did his job, finished up the inning, and Adelaide still have the lead, 3-2.
So Brunneman predicted it. said that he might, if they can get it in the right position, he might come out and finish this one off. And although the lefty will continue on in the pen, but just in case for the right-left sort of match-up, he suggests that the righty will step on out again. So Adelaide Bite, right back to the top of the lineup here.
Lead-off hitter Brandon Dixon, after making a great play to end the Bandits inning, up to bat.
He takes a breaker, which is just down low, over the plate, but too low. 1-2-5 clicks for big Daniel Cooper. Brandon Dixon, who should be charged up and ready to go after a beautiful play that saved the bacon there a little bit for the Bite. And again, some great scouting. He was playing shallow right field there, and Goofy obliged and hit it straight to him, although he had an absolute rope at him. He really needed to hang tough and just sit with it, and he did. He took it and then had to get at least a 40-metre throw to Miller. He swung around and gleefully received. And it was a little saver for the Bite. So as we've mentioned a few times, we've got a real ball game on our hands here. A one runner, bottom of the eighth. Dixon, broken bat, third base. Nielsen collects it and just took it very casually and put one in the dirt to Goofy, and it bounced off the heel, so Dixon gets on.
Nielsen had all the time in the world there. Unfortunately, the bat has snapped on the hit. Nielsen had plenty of time, but unfortunately he's put it in the dirt to the first baseman, and he's heeled it and put it into the dirt, so Dixon safe at first.
So Timmy picks up the splinters, and the Barbie will be on tonight, and that will be the end of Cooper. We'll see Goto come out for his second appearance in this series. We'll take a short break, and we'll be back again. Welcome back. Pitching change for the Bandits. Masato Goto rolls out. A pretty tight little moment. He's gone. The playbook is out and it is being run to the letter right at the moment. And Dening squares around a bunt. Bunt's foul.
Yeah, Dening known for his long hitting, but Brooke Knight's called upon him to get that runner over to second base by laying down a bunt. Unfortunately, dragged it foul.
I reckon that might have been his one and only chance. No, he sort of put his hand on the end of the bat again, so he might be squaring around again. Gokta ponders and delivers and takes downstairs, one and one. Always an intriguing part of the game, this one, where it's cat and mouse. And it might believe that it's an easy thing to advance bunt, but it's not. Because you've still got to make this guy throw a strike, and you've got to still bunt something that you can manage. And Goto will be trying to get a bit of twist on the ball and make life as difficult as possible, especially to a lefty. You got that funky little turn right at the end.
You
have a look at that centre field camera.
You can see what Adelaide are trying to do here. They're trying to manufacture a run, none out. Trying to get that runner on first base over to second by Dening sacrificing his time at bat. So they're looking for an insurance run here in the bottom of the eighth.
So Denning's job to get the ball down, and Dixon's job is to wait till it gets down. Dening takes inside. So good hitting by Mitch. Not making life easy for anyone here. Making Goto throw a strike.
This will be interesting spells whether Brooke Knight continues to try and get this bunt laid down.
3-1 count. None out.
Mitch Dening in the
bottom eight.
Perfect position for a hitting.
And I think he actually wanted to hit. So he bunts another foul. Says, all right, well, now you got no choice. You got to let me swing away. Well, maybe. But
I've seen it in the past, the spells. Coach might get his hitter to still lay this one down. He's looking for that security run.
You suggest he'll be hitting. Swinging. Goto goes over to first, and Millett walks back in. So, Dixon. Just ask for time. Dixon at first base, just to ensure that his terra firma is exactly how he wants it. And he gets his lead again, and we resume.
Goto prepares to throw. Mitch Dening pulls that one foul.
Straight into the Brisbane bullpen, and the boys that were doing some protection work on the pitcher, warming up. Took a nice little bit of ground ball action. A little bit more action over there as well. Samuel Holland warming up. Fidge warming up as well, but more than likely Tolles will probably step on out in the ninth with a couple of lefties coming to the plate. So Goethe sets again and pauses, takes his time outside.
That pitch misses,
and that scoreboard was wrong. Had us at a full count, but we're at a full count now. So a big moment. Sorry, Rev, I keep talking over you.
This is the money pitch right here.
He strikes out.
Good running by
Dixon. Takes the bag.
Good running by Dixon. Delayed his steal to second. Mitch Dening strikes out on the pitch. Caught the catcher unaware. So the job of Dening, really, even though he struck out, the job's been done. The runner's advanced to second. Put him in a scoring position.
Number 29, first baseman Aaron Miller.
So Tizenbaum goes out and has a quick chat with Masato. Like to be a fly on the wall and hear that little conversation.
Obviously Goto,
please throw strike,
has a grasp of the English language. No interpreter required on that one.
So another lefty comes in and he stays right on that pitch and puts a good swing on it. Foul ball. The crowd very much still right into this game.
Adelaide crowd can sense that something might be happening here. Security run coming up.
There's a comeback straight at him. He spun around and looked at Dixon, who was a fair way off his bag, but he opted for the easier out. So Miller grounds out to the pitcher.
Two out, the bottom of the eight. Brings to bat third baseman, Steph Welch.
Couple of strikeouts tonight and a pop fly to shortstop.
Time for Steph to earn his money.
Not easy. Typically of the, again, the style that a lot of Asian pitchers adopt, especially left versus left, and he swings right around and throws that leg out a little bit, so he's really just coming at your front kneecap, which is never easy, and he gets one over for strike one.
You're spot on there, Spills. It's very tough for a lefty-lefty combination. Steph's got to hold tough here and keep that front shoulder in.
No doubt seen this many a time. Goto just steps off the back and spins around and doesn't have to throw the ball, and doesn't. So one or two here would be super handy for the Bite. And he gets a little check swing and chops it back between his legs. Foul ball. Hope you're enjoying things wherever you may be. This beautiful country and world of ours. Seeing a really good competitive matchup from a couple of teams here, and obviously the Bite have the ascendancy through a couple of wins. But the Bandits are right around the mark.
Adelaide can't afford to let their guard down. You're right there, Spells. We need a good time at bat here from our third baseman, Steph Welch. Hasn't had the greatest of nights, but baseball's a lovely game. That one time at bat can redeem you.
So Goto comes again. And Welch gets a little broken batter into centre left field. Dixon will score. Welch gets the job done with a little flare to centre left field.
Finally, I've got one right. I've put the moguls on the hitters or the pitchers about three times tonight, and I've luckily got Steph Welch to hit into centre field with a little chinker.
Exactly what you asked him to do, Rev. He kept that front shoulder in and he sat with it and he squared it up. Didn't hit it exactly like he would have wanted, but enough of the barrel was there to get the job done. So Welch picks himself up an RBI single at a very crucial moment, bottom eight. Give the Bite a little bit more insurance.
Rocky Gale to the plate. Goto prepares. Fastball. Strike one.
Again, Goto sets and delivers. Gale doing a good job. Saw a low pitch get called. another one go, just taking it out of the umpire's hands and taking charge for himself.
Just opened up his zone a little bit. Steph Wilkes has a good lead at first base.
And the boys have done a good job tonight, all the umpires. It's been a well-controlled game and a lot of good decision-making by them. And that's outside. And Tisenbaum, in an attempt for a little backdoor piff to first, lost the handle.
Can't afford to have any mistakes by Tisenbaum like that. Luckily, Steph Welch wasn't at an advantage to take second base as the ball slipped out of Tisenbaum's hand. Gale prepares for the pitch. Goto misses outside. 2-2 count.
Rocky Gale looking to pick himself up a base hit and keep this alive for the Bite. Sits and waits, and there's time called, and Goto gets one over the plate.
Goto took his time on that pitch, and Gale obviously was unsettled, so he's asked for time. Blake Culligan's obliged with that one. Two out, 2-2 count.
Welsh with a good lead. And Rocky swings at that. That was outside, but he got the toe of the bat on it enough to just hang tough and stay alive. So 2-2 the count, two out. Welsh on first. Gale in the box. Bite leading it by a couple. 4-2 ball game. Just beautiful conditions. Not a breath of wind out there. It is just picture perfect. Goto sets himself up again. And delivers. And Gale again. A good AB for him. Been a little down on numbers in the offensively. But not through lack of trying. And he's picked himself up some RBIs, which is important.
This is a good time at bat by Gale. Clearly seeing the ball very well. Just got to get that bat in the right position. Steph Welch gets his lead at first base as Goto prepares to throw the pitch. Outside. Excellent time at bat by Rocky Gale. Full count.
One of those moments. Goto got to get it over, and Gale got to put his best swing on it. And he comes, and he pops it. Goofy going over, staying fairly in the field of play.
Great call by Neil Poulton.
Just had his toe over the line.
Goofy had his foot either over the line or on the line, and Neil Poulton's made a great call there. Savior there for Rocky Gale. Full count still. Goto prepares to throw his next pitch.
First baseman not holding. Welsh takes off, and that ball driven center right field. It has got, no it hasn't, yes it has, got through Josh Roberts out there at right field. Rocky Gale wheeling around to third base. He gets himself a triple. Welsh scores.
For a moment there,
put their fifth on the board.
For a moment there, I thought the right fielder had taken that ball, but it has just evaded him, and
Seth Welch scores from first base and Rocky Gale ends up on third base. Another security run for Adelaide.
Great effort out there by Roberts. He really got on his bike and just tracked it perfectly. In a full stretch dive, he was right around the mark. So a magnificent effort out there, and that might be the end of go two, as they will come with Erasmus. And boy, game of inches again. And poor old Masato. We'll take a seat. We'll take a short break. We'll see you in here in a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, leaving the ball game is Masato Goto, and he is replaced on the mound for the Brisbane Bandits by number 36, Justin Erasmus. Erasmus, number 36, now pitching for the Bandits.
Welcome back. A Rocky Gale line drive into centre right field just evaded the sprawling Josh Roberts in an extraordinary effort out there by Josh. And Erasmus starts it up, fastball down and out.
That hit by Rocky Gale has probably broken the back of the Bandits here tonight.
Lodge with an attempted check swing, but
Blake Halligan deemed that he'd had followed through on that one. 1-1 count.
So Erasmus again. Runner on third, gets a breaking pitch and just leaves it up a tad.
Erasmus looks like he's got a good quality breaking ball there, a 12-6 breaking ball. That one just not coming down enough. 2-1 count.
So with the shift on again, it'd be nice to see Lodgy rid some demons and get some nice lumber on it, wherever it may go. You need some good contact just to reaffirm to himself, and that's down. So Lodge picks a walk.
That's good discipline batting in the batting box there by Ben Lodge. Hasn't had the greatest of night, but still enables himself to grab a walk.
The shortstop, Chan Jong Foo.
We're kids. So Erasmus Moon again just gets an inside pitch and just pulls off of it.
That's Moon's style though, just not getting the lumber on that one.
So runners in the corners, two out, bottom eight, little two out rally by the Bite, and again a beautifully executed
change up or perhaps another curveball. Really, as you said, Rev, just really ripping over the top of them and getting some nice late break. Too good for Moon on that occasion.
Yeah, he's got good, very good 12 to 6 movement straight down.
Tisenbaum just heads up the infield with the proposed first and third play. So Erasmus again, another breaking pitch, and he chops it to the ground. Foul ball. So 0-2 count, Moon hanging in there, and Erasmus giving him a die to breaking pitches. He just might be setting him up to piff one straight through those letters and see if he can get him with some cheese. No. Sort of. 121 case. Good enough anyway. So Moon strikes out. The Bite put a couple on the board. Some very valuable insurance runs for them. Three outs away from sealing this Game 3 victory. Stick with us. We'll see you soon.
SA Power Networks employs more than 2,000 South Australians and delivers electricity to around 40,000 customers. We don't make electricity, and we don't sell it either. What we do is deliver electricity to your home. From the Rundle Lantern to our airport, hospitals, schools and traffic lights, power is vital to the function of our state. That's why our team is on call 24/7, rain, hail or shine, to respond to any emergency. Plus, we're taking the initiative to ensure that everyone can access information about their power supply however and wherever they like. We also foster vital connections through more than a dozen community sponsorships. At SA Power Networks, we're working with you to deliver the power you need, now and in the future. SA Power.
So welcome back, everyone. Tyler Bruneman, you're going to have another crack at this and see if he can. I'll do it myself, boss. I'll do it myself.
And that's what the manager wants, someone on the hill that wants the ball in his hand. Adelaide Bite three outs away from taking the series 3-0.
Yes, they are. And it'd be good for Tyler because he's done some good work but probably hasn't got much to show for it as such. So it'd be nice for him to be out there at the end and get a win. Not for himself but just for his team, and he's the man that's doing it for him. Moving pretty quickly out there. Trying to keep things ticking along. Shrugs that one off and he says, this is what I want to throw. He misses outside. Now he gets it across. 1-2, the count.
It looked like a good change up, that pitch. Batter didn't want to swing, but the pitch took enough of the plate.
And it's interesting to watch him when he really tries to jet one up a little bit. He really throws that weight out to the side and he just misses outside. Nice pitch.
Tyler needs to get the radar back on song here. Don't want to put the lead-off batter on the base.
And strikes him out. So the Rebel is on fire up here at the moment. Calling him as he's seeing it. So Kay Cole to lead off Campbell.
It's pretty disappointing by Campbell there. Full count. You've got to open your zone up a bit. Can't have that bat resting on the shoulder.
Bruneman misses inside. Ball one.
But on the flip side, Bruneman's done his job. Gets the first out.
And gets strike one over. So he's working quickly. got a little head of steam up, nice rhythm, and he gets one across again.
You can just see the confidence that Tyler's giving us here at the moment. Give me the ball, I'll throw you the strikes.
There's a fly ball straight away centre field. Dening did not have to move.
That was a great change up by Tyler there. Batter had to swing at it. Didn't have any power on it. And he's given an easy catch to Mitch Dening out at centre field. Adelaide are one out away from grabbing this game.
And again, I'd like to thank my great team, Dening, Peter White and Jim Manning. And my cohort here, Ian Revel, who's always a good buddy and always good value in the commentary box. So thanks, Ian, for coming up again.
Always a pleasure, Spills.
It's Bruneman. Little chopper back to his bench for a foul ball. So 0-2.
Might not be able to do it for too much longer if the Cavs fall the right way.
Well, it'll be really fantastic if that occurs, Ian. So we wish you all the best. It's been a really quick journey for you and you're not far away, so it'd be awesome to see you out there officiating. So Logan Wade with the job to do for the Bandits to keep them alive. He flies that left field. Corey Lyon swifts those hands and says, "Give it to me, baby." And the Adelaide Bite get game three done. So they're 3-0 up in this series. All on a wonderful start from Morgan Coombs. You'd have to put him down again as the player of the match.
Most definitely. He set that game up from the word go with 6 1/3 strong innings. Really set the win up for Adelaide tonight.
And then the bullpen did the job. Will Mathis and Tyler Bruneman cleaned him up and got the job done. And a nice start from Takashio too. He did a good job, just couldn't quite last the distance. And a blast from Dening and a blast from Lyon and a hit from Maddox, or a couple of hits from Maddox and Gale, and that's pretty much about it. It was a tight little ball game and the Adelaide Bite take it 5-2. You've enjoyed yourself. I hope we've enjoyed ourselves. I hope you have at home.
Certainly have.
We'll be back tomorrow, 1 o'clock Adelaide time, for the matinee Sunday game, and we will stay live here where Eric will interview one of the Adelaide Bite, which we'll stick with. So we'll see you back here tomorrow, 1 o'clock.
Good night.
I'm down here on the field with Morgan Coombs. Morgan, fantastic start once again. How does it feel? You had your stuff going today.
Yeah, it was a good night tonight. Got rushed a little bit out there, but kind of got me fired up and got the job done.
So you had no earned runs tonight, and you had 8 strikeouts. Your ERA keeps lowering and lowering and lowering. Getting a bit more comfortable in this league?
Absolutely, yeah. It's the more innings you throw, the more comfortable you get out there and the defense behind you.
3 straight against the Brisbane Bandits. What would it mean to get the sweep?
You always got to go for a sweep. It'd be good. Football club, we got to come out tomorrow and ready to play.
Now, 5 of 6 now. Tell the fans here that are all in the stands leaving right now, what are you guys feeling right now as a group in the locker room?
We feel good. You know, we got a confident team. Come out here every day trying to win, ready to win a championship. So, one game at a time.
Morgan, thanks a lot. Fans, give it up for Morgan Coombs.